Escape from the Planet of the Apes is a 1971 sci-fi film directed by Don Taylor and starring Roddy McDowall, Kim Hunter, Bradford Dillman, Natalie Trundy, Eric Braeden, and Ricardo Montalban. The film opens with a chopper and a spaceship. The military arrive for a rescue mission and they sure do look friendly. They pull the ship in as a brass arrives.
Welcome, gentlemen, to the United
States. Holy shit! Hey, look at this Instagram post. They go to a military base with M. Emmett Walsh.
Have they been fed raw steak or something?
The zoo tells me that chimpanzees, like all apes, are vegetarian, sir. They suggested oranges.
Fucking commies. So they're sent to the L.A. Zoo.
But we saw the Earth destroyed.
And Earth will be destroyed just as we saw it. Only since seeing it, we have passed through a backward disturbance in time.
Convenient! Doctors Dixon and Brenton arrive and start checking them out. What the hell is this? Perfection! There, earn your breakfast.
Well, why doesn't she take it?
Because I loathe bananas.
Zero.
Well, being quiet lasted long. An argument ensues, then this happens. Holy shit!
You'll need a full autopsy.
With special emphasis on the cranial and oral areas.
Let us know when the report comes in, will you please?
Yeah, bub. We'll get right to that.
I'm a psychiatrist.
Oh, well, I'm a psychiatrist, too.
You guys may know each other on LinkedIn.
Nobody's going to believe this.
Believe what?
Well, the primitive apes can talk.
Primitive?
Nice job offending them.
May I say something personal?
Please.
I like you.
Why? That's not Nixon.
I have therefore decided to convene a presidential commission of inquiry in Los Angeles tomorrow.
The skivvy gets dropped and here's the media circus. I'm just here waiting for the report on golden tickets. And the hearing chair is Clark W. Griswold, Sr.
Not by signs, not by looks or movements, but by words.
I hear a great deal of harumph.
Does the other one talk?
Only when she lets me.
As to humans, I've examined thousands of.
Oh, maybe keep that on the down low.
We saw the Earth destroyed.
Look at her face. She can't take much more of this. Haslin goes on television because he's probably working on a book deal.
Well, then maybe the explanation needs some explaining. Now, you've written several learned dissertations on the nature of time.
It's learned.
Or regresses and paints a picture of the artist painting a picture of the landscape. But still something is missing. And that something is still his real self painting the second picture.
Are you high right now?
Infinite regression, then, is...
It is the moment when our artist has regressed to the point of infinity, and himself becomes part of the landscape he painted, and is both the observer and the observed.
Doc Brown explained this better.
I think that by their intelligence and their good humor, the two so-called aponauts have already captured the hearts of the entire American nation.
That means you're getting merch. Lots and lots of merch. There's a tour of the city planned and a hotel room full of swag. And they each get a makeover.
Madam Zira, I represent Fur and Feather, a pet magazine. And
do you think I'm a pet?
Well, yes, I do, rather.
Bitch.
Well, it's sort of like Grape Juice Plus. Wait, just a sip.
Zira is going to get loaded. That looks safe. Cornelius goes to a prize fight, which he hates, and Zira checks out a museum.
Must have been the shock.
Shock my foot. I'm pregnant.
How long was that ship ride?
I have a strange craving.
That is only natural.
For Grape Juice Plus.
Grape Juice Plus.
If she's pregnant, she shouldn't be drinking. Haslam whips out his iPod and gets Zira drunk so she'll talk more freely. Then he passes it to the president.
Alter what you believe to be the course of the future by slaughtering two innocents, or rather three, now that one of them is pregnant.
The hell? Then he tells Haslam to step off.
White, blinding light.
Brighter than this?
Cliché!
In the course of less than two centuries, they progressed from performing mere tricks to performing services.
Have to set up the next movie, even though it'll only be 20 years and not a couple hundred. They bring in Dixon to give Zira some truth serum, and she admits to doing her job. Cornelius is pissed, and then room service arrives.
You better drink your soup and eat the oranges for the sake of that, little monkey you got.
Fair reaction. How soft was his head? They immediately get off the base and Zira's labor starts. And here comes the army. Brenton finds Cornelius, and I swear she is wearing that expression in the entire movie. Dixon meets with Armando to discuss keeping them undercover in a circus.
You are asking me to risk imprisonment for the sake of two fugitive apes? Well, the answer is 1,000 times yes.
Man, that was easy. Here comes the birth and done. G-rated movie, folks. Haslam realizes they may be hiding and demands a search of all zoos and circuses, so the plants are shot to shit and they have to leave again. Here, take my gun. That leaves me with an even dozen. They're going to find that bag. See? Haslam figures out where they're at and nobody hears him stomping around. Then everyone else shows up.
I want that baby. If you won't give it to me, I'll shoot.
Holy shit! Holy shit! I'm not crying, you are. Meanwhile, back at the circus. Escape from the Planet of the Apes is much better than Beneath. The remainder of this series is all going to be a prequel to the first film. So you know where we're going with all this. Man screws up and destroys himself over and over again. This film starts out fun, but gets darker and darker, and is a great example of the 1970s G. Overall, it's a decent middle chapter to the Ape Saga.
This cage stinks of gorilla.